Hi, everyone. My name is Tosin. I'm a consultant at Nexi Concept Limited. Here we are today. Actually, we just want to speak on the Saskatchewan Immigration Nominee Program for Canada. Yeah, I can see some people waving already. Thank you for joining. So I will just go straight and I will start, you know, talking about the program. It's a pathway program. I'm sure we are all aware of, you know, different immigration programs that Canada runs. You know, we have the Express Entry that everybody is aware of. I'm sure everybody knows Express Entry. We have the other provincial nominee programs, and SIMP is just one of the provincial nominee programs currently in process, you know, when it comes to immigration pathway to Canada. Thank you guys for joining, and I'm sure, you know, several persons also must have submitted an expression of interest for this particular program, the SIMP program, you know, but this is just to take us through step by step, you know, free of charge. So this is not a charge process. This is what we are just doing, basically to assist people through the pool. You know, it doesn't really make sense when we just, you know, people that even maybe 61, 65, you know, submitting an expression of interest would probably eventually be expunged out of the pool, because I'm not sure they are going to come down anytime soon. So, but I just want us to, you know, also make sure that we have the right calculation in the expression of interest in the pool, because if you don't have the right calculation of, you know, all the indices they put together, then definitely if peradventure eventually we get, you know, the ITA, that's the invitation to submit the application for SIM, I'm afraid that we may eventually be denied, because I've had cases like that where some people just submit the expression of interest, you know, based on their, you know, the information available to them, limited information available to them. So they just submit the expression of interest, and they were just called, they were just sent an ITA, and after that they started putting those documents together, and they submitted. And after submitting the application for SIM, that's after they must have paid like $350 Canadian for the SIM application itself. Eventually, they were denied, all because, you know, they failed to put into consideration the right indices. That is wrong representation. You know, that is very key and very, very important for you, you know, to consider when we are talking about the SIMP. Now, strictly, the program SIMP in Saskatchewan has like three major categories, basically. That's like three major categories. There is the international skilled worker, which is the employment offer route. There is the international skilled worker, which is the Saskatchewan express entry route. And the third one is the international skilled worker, which is the occupation in demand route. So, and today I just want to talk about the international skilled worker, which is the occupation in demand. So I'm not going to talk about the other two categories, basically. So, because that other international skilled worker, Saskatchewan Express Entry route, is basically for someone who wants to also be in the Express Entry pool, which is the general pool, the federal government pool, and at the same time wants to get the what's it called, the SIMP, you know, so that because once you get the SIMP invite, it will give you about 600 points. You can then add it with your expression of interest in the Express Entry pool. That will definitely shoot your point up in the Express Entry pool, and you can then use that, you know, to get ITA from the federal government, you know. But when it comes to the international skilled worker, which is the occupation in demand route, is actually what we want to discuss here. Thank you, Michael Gavin. Thanks for joining. I can see you're already speaking in Yoruba and Igbo. Yeah, already. Thank you so much. Thanks for joining. So that's if anybody wondering, that's our rep for Highland, Michael Gavin from National College of Highland. So that's the one waving and speaking, you know, different dialect, different language in your in that Yoruba and Igbo. So thank you, welcome, Michael Gavin. So let me just quickly rush through the international skilled worker occupations in demand. Now there are jobs that are in demand in Canada. Sorry, yes, in Canada, because Saskatchewan is actually in Canada. So, but we're actually talking about Saskatchewan now. So there are jobs that are in demand in Saskatchewan. They have the list of those jobs also on their website. And it is very, very important that you go through the list, you know, view it, evaluate it side by side with your experience before you can actually apply, you know, to this program. It is very, very important, you know, to go through it. And this is where some people actually miss it, because some people, there are some, you know, jobs listed in that in-demand list, and they feel like I'm not qualified for this, I'm not qualified for this, you know. You can actually get, if you have like a company that you can actually source documentations for as regards this particular job or that description, you can actually approach the company, you know, but the company must be legit. It is very, very important. The company must be legit so that you don't get banned at the end of the day. So make sure that the company is legit and the company is ready to give you the documentation. So review that in-demand list. It is very, very important for Saskatchewan. So for those that are currently, that are just joining us, I'm just discussing the last, what's it called? One out of the three routes for this SIMP program, you know, in Saskatchewan, that's in Canada. So, and I'm discussing the international skilled worker occupations in demand. And where I stopped is the fact that I was saying that there are occupations listed in this category, which is the occupations in demand. You need to get it, it's on your website. And if you also need it, you can chat me up. I can give you, you know, I have it in PDF format. I can send it to you. You need to go through it, review it. It is very, very important for you to review it and see it is what you can actually get documentations for. Sorry about that. So I will just move ahead to discuss the indices they use, basically. Before you can actually submit an expression of interest, if you consider the indices from the education to the language ability to the, you know, work experience, you know, to the your age and, you know, connection to Saskatchewan labor market and adaptability, you need to have nothing less than a minimum of 60 points. That is what is required for you to submit an expression of interest. You need to have 60 points. It is very, very important. And this is how they actually come about the 60 points. The first indices I would want to discuss is basically the education and the training. You know, it is very, very important that you know what your education qualification is, so that you can actually evaluate it with words. Now, what do I mean by that? I've seen many persons that actually misrepresent themselves here in terms of the education and training point. You know, the education and training point, depending on your qualification, does have each point allocated to, you know, each qualifications. Like master's degree, you have 23 points to pick up there. Like bachelor's degree, at least you must have spent like 3 years in, you know, college or university. You have like 20 points to pick there. You know, also for the trade certification equivalent to the journey person status in Saskatchewan. Yes, the journey person status also, you know, they have the a document explaining the journey person status. So you need to check it side by side if your trade certification, you know, goes in line with it. So you can read it up on their website as well. And if you also need the document for the journey person status in Saskatchewan, I can as well send it to you. You can chat me up after this live program. So that trade certification requires you, you know, you can pick up 20 points also from that. And if you have a diploma, if your diploma is about two years or less than 3 years at a university in or colleges or trade or technical schools or other post-secondary institution done in Canada, Canada equivalent, you can also pick up that's a 15 point. And for certificate less than two semesters, you know, you can pick up 12 points. Now, I was saying something about misrepresentation, you know, here. This is how people misrepresent themselves when it comes to the education. Now, we have people that are probably have studied something like mechanical engineering or anything in engineering, you know, anything in medicine, anything in, you know, law, anything that requires you to actually spend 5 years and above in the university. Now, people make mistake of evaluating that particular qualification with words. When you evaluate that kind of qualification with words, we definitely evaluate that qualification as a 4 years degree. So you have lost some points there. When it comes to ICAS or IQAS, they can actually evaluate this same 4 or 5 years degree as a master's degree level when it comes to this ICAS and IQAS. And this is how you can actually pick up, you know, more points in education and also in the training aspect. So instead of you, someone who have studied mech engine or civil engine, and you have probably spent 5 years in the university, you don't need to, you know, evaluate with words. Just use up the other two, what's it called, body I just mentioned, ICAS and IQAS, to get your evaluation done, and you can easily pick up 23 points, which is the highest points for the education and training under the Saskatchewan Immigration Nominee Program, you know, in the route of, that's the International Skilled Occupation in Demand. Now, I will move to the next indices where people would also misrepresent whenever they are submitting an expression of interest, which is actually the, what's it called, the skilled work experience. Yes, you know, for the first 5 years prior to when you are actually submitting, when you're actually submitting the expression of interest, if you probably have had like 5 years experience in the NOC you are choosing for this particular program, in the NOC you are choosing for this particular program, then if you have up to 5 years experience, you can pick up another 10 points. You know, you can pick up another 10 points. And in the last 6 to 10 years prior to the application submission date, that is your expression of interest now, you can pick up, if you have another 5 years, you can pick up, what's it called, another 5 points. And if you have that together, that means if you have about 10 years experience in your NOC, you can pick up as much as 15 points under the work experience. Now, some people will say, I've gotten several inquiries, and I've also done for someone like that who actually finished, you know, the degree, and the person did not count the the NYSE experience. You know, he left out the NYSE experience and started counting when he actually got his first job. So the point is, like I said the other time when I started, I was saying that if you can find a company that can actually give you documentation that you are sure of, and they can give you documentation for this number of years, all you just need to do, then, like I said, confirm, you know, if the company is legit, it's very, very important, you know, and you confirm the establishment or the operation year of the company, because a company that wants to give you, say, 10 years experience should be established before, you know, 10 years. You know, you can't get a company that probably got established and started operation sometimes around last 2 or 3 years, and you want to claim 10 years experience from that company because they can give you documentations. That will not work. That will be a wrong representation, and probably if you don't get banned for that kind of practice, then you will not be, you know, your application will not be moved forward. So it's very, very important, because after you pass through the expression of interest stage, you will move on to the documentation stage, which is the SIMP application itself. That means you're going to submit some documents to validate everything you have said in your expression of interest. So it is very key. Now, what I'm saying, in essence, before I actually talked about that, is the fact that if you have graduated a long time, more than 10 years ago, and you don't actually have the, you know, the number of years of experience they are actually looking for here, you know, for you to get the 15 points, that means you need to have about 10 years experience. So, and if you graduated long time ago, more than 10 years now, you can actually claim it if you can get a company that can give you such documentations. And I've said, such company that is giving you such documentations must have, you know, been established before this time, and also they must have started operation before this time. And I am not saying, this is not what I am saying, that if you just graduated some few years ago, maybe it's not up to 10 years, and you are trying to now get 10 years experience, and you are now getting a company that can give you 10 years experience, the documentations that can give you 10 years experience, that is not what I'm saying. It won't work that way, because they are going to check all the indices, the year you finished your degree, the year you started, and even the company. Definitely, they are going to check all these indices. It's very, very important. So now, if you have any question, you can actually drop the question. I will attend to all the questions after this program. So if you have any questions, just drop it while the live is actually going on. So that is that for the work experience. Now, for the language ability, some people also misrepresent here, because many people cannot actually calculate the CLB. you know, it is very, very important. If you don't know how to calculate the CLB with your highest score, you need to get, you know, assistance, you know, with this. So if you need to get the right CLB to be imputed in your expression of interest, also kindly reach out to us. We will do it for you for free. It is not a charged, you know, services, basically. So if you need to calculate it, it is very, don't submit a wrong CLB. It is more like a wrong representation. Like I said, you can get a ban for it, and as well you can, your application will be discontinued. So that is very, very important. You know, for you to get the highest point for, let's say you've written IELTS English, basically, you need to have, you know, okay, I will not do the calculations because of our time here. So because I wanted to do the calculation initially, but if you need the calculation, please reach out to us. You can send a chat and I will respond to that. And personally, I would, you know, do that for you. So I can see CZ, sorry if I'm not pronouncing that name properly. If you want to ask any questions, you, like I said, just type your questions. I will attend to it after the live program. So the required CLB for the language ability is actually for CLB 4. So if you have even as low as CLB 4, you can actually still apply. So it's between CLB 4 to CLB 10. So before you can actually determine, you know, what CLB you have, then, like I said, you need an assistant, you know, for you to be able to calculate it with your IELTS score and get you the right CLB, so that you don't impute the wrong thing on your expression of interest, you know, for the SIMP. So they have for English as well. They also have for French. So for those who speak and write French, you know, fluently, you can actually write French test as well. It can also boost your point. So the highest point you can get for that is 10 if you're on CLB 8, and for English the highest point you can get for IELTS is 20 points if you're on CLB 8. So if you want to know if you're on CLB 8 or 7, 6, 9, or 4, all you just need to do is send your IELTS score to me and I will go through it and use the tables provided by the on Canada website to calculate it for you properly. So another indices I would talk about here is the age. You know, it's very, very important for you to consider this aspect properly, though it is very easy for you to calculate and know the right point you are going to impute for yourself. Like it stated here, 0 points for people less than 18 years. You know, from 18 to 21, you have 8 points. 22 to 34, you have 12 points, and it goes on and on and on. So if you're above 50, you have 0 points. So that means above 50, you cannot get points for this particular program. So I think it stops at 46 to 50, which gives you like the least point for age, which is 8 points. Now, before I move further, let me explain quickly, because this particular program, like I said, you can use it in two ways. Now, you can use this particular program if you are eventually given ITA to apply directly for permanent residency. You can use the ITA to apply directly for permanent residency if you are applying under the in-demand category. But if you are applying under the second category, which is the International Skilled Worker Saskatchewan Express Entry, you must have submitted expression of interest, you know, in the federal pool before you can actually do this one, basically, because in the process of your submission of expression of interest for this particular program, they will ask you for your job seeker code. So if you don't have a job seeker code, which will be, you know, given to you after you are done with your expression of interest with Express Entry, you won't be able to move further with this application. So if you have the job seeker code, you will move further. And if you are given ITA, you know, in this particular program, then you can use, because the ITA is equal to about 600 points on its own. So you can add it to this particular, to your Express Entry. You can add it to your Express Entry, and obviously to shoot up your points. I mean, the point currently on, you know, Express Entry is, I think from the last draw, is around 470 something. So obviously, if you have an ITA from this particular program, even without your Express Entry score, you can easily apply. 600 is a whole lot of points. So, and by the time, even though you have about 300, that's a whole lot for you to move further with your Express Entry. So, but here we're actually talking about, you know, going directly, the route that will make you just apply directly without going through the Express Entry pool, which is the occupations in demand. So that is very key. You need to consider that. And now, the last point I just want to discuss here is that of the connection, which is the factor two, is that of the connection to Saskatchewan labor market. Under it, you have, you know, close family relative in Saskatchewan. So there is a point allocated to that, huge point for that matter, that I believe anyone could easily pick up if you have a family. So it is not restricted like Express Entry, which is restricted to your siblings, either your brother or your sister. It is not restricted. You can get, you know, if you have any siblings, like, you know, your niece, nephew, cousin, step family members, you know, or in-laws of the same relationship, you know, grandparents, parents, siblings, you know, any of these categories can actually stand for you, give you the documentation, you know, to prove family relationship. Now, this person, we need to consider the indices, because it's very, very important. You cannot forge this. And if you actually want to get someone to stand in for you, then you must consider there's a required document that explains properly what this person will do for you. So you need to speak, if you have anybody that actually wants to stand in for you, that means that person must actually go through that particular document, you know, for you to prove the relationship. The things they will be needing from them, they need to be sure they'll be having it, and they will be able to provide it for you when the time comes. It is very, very important. This is how many people get, you know, banned eventually. So because they don't consider the document at first, they just say, oh, okay, I will get somebody to stand in if I pay the person. At the end of the day, some of the documents they'll be asking from the person won't be able to provide it, and there will be a problem at this point. So it's very, very important for you to consider the required document, the family member or the supposed person that will be standing in for you as your family would need to provide. Now, they must also be a permanent resident candidate in Canada, and they or, you know, a citizen of Canada, basically living in Saskatchewan, not outside Saskatchewan. So that means if they are saying that living in Saskatchewan, that means they must be working in Saskatchewan. That means they are going to get their work documents as well. They are also going to get their rent documents. So it's very, very, very important. A lot of things to be considered, you know, from that angle. Now, if you also have in the job in demand, there are also some jobs, you know, like I said, that will be listed in the documents. If you ask me, I'm going to get it for you. If you can get an offer of employment from, you know, a Saskatchewan employer, then you can actually use it. This is another 30 points to prove, you know, from this particular indices. 30 points to prove. You know, you can claim these 30 points if you can get a job. Now, I've gotten several persons, basically. They've asked me, do I have probably someone who can offer them job in Canada, all of those things, or can I get an agency in Canada that can, you know, get them job offers and all of those things. So I'll just tell people to be careful. You know, there are quite a number of agencies, even in Canada, they're actually, you know, not legit. They've scammed a lot of persons already, and job is not easy, you know, as you know, the way people are painting it, job is not easy to get in Canada. Even people currently who are living in Canada, who are citizens, or who probably they've gotten their permanent residency, they are also looking for job in Canada. It's not as if you can pick it up on the street, obviously. So it's not that easy to pick up. You know, people that have seen, you know, from my experience, you know, in this job, that I know they've gotten some opportunity to get, you know, job offers easily, are probably IT. And I'm not talking about people that are just learning, you know, codes or just IT from yesterday. I'm talking about people that are well experienced in IT. I'm talking about creative, you know, guys in IT. I'm not, yeah, when I'm talking about IT now, I'm talking about people who are gurus in IT. These are people that they've, you know, they've already gotten offer, and they don't even need all this pathway to actually get it. So the job offer they get is you know, enough for them to get, you know, skilled worker visa for them to apply and just go to Canada. So after spending some few years in Canada working, they can easily get process their permanent residency. So skilled work, high skilled work employment offer is not easy. Let's have that in mind. So that's the reason I've not talked about it, because there are quite a number of scams ongoing on that. So, and I don't have an option as regards that at the moment. That's why I'm not talking about it. So the one I'm sure people can still, you know, work around is that of close relationship. So because I've seen some persons done it. So probably you just need to pay the person if you know anybody in Canada that can stand in for you. So that is basically the most important indices we may need to consider today under the International Skilled Worker Occupation in Demand. So like I said, I will just go through some of your questions here. Then thank you for your compliments. I really appreciate. Okay. Does one need to have family or friends before you could apply to this province? Actually, you don't need to have family or friends. If you have, I'm not sure of friends, but probably friends can still stand for you if they can provide those documentations and you guys can talk how you can relate, you know, how you guys, you know, can prove the relationship between you as family. So, but there is no point for friends. So the only point that is available that I know is that of family. So if you have a family, it will only increase your points and you'll be selected from the pool as soon as possible. So, but at the same time, you don't need to have a family before you can submit your expression of interest. If you can do well in your, education and your work experience, and also the language ability with your age, then you should have a good point for you to submit an expression of interest. And hopefully, you should be able to, even if you're not selected within 2 to 3 months, then you should be hopeful of getting, being selected within 4 or 5 months, if peradventure the point drops. But the categories of people that will be selected within 2 or 3 months, are people probably around 70 and above, maybe 75, 80, 70. You can still be in the point, and probably in the next, say, 2, 3, 4, 5 maximum month, you should be, getting an ITA. But for people within 80, 75 points, can, expect to get an ITA for, what's it called, in the next 2, 3 months. So that is it. So which evaluation body is appropriate for evaluating a bachelor's degree in civil engineering? Okay, all the evaluation body from WES, from ICAS, from IQAS, all the evaluation body are very much appropriate to actually evaluate your qualification. But I was saying that it is very good, it will be very, very good for your, for shooting up your point if you evaluate your degree, most importantly, when you have studied, a degree in engineering course. It will be very much appropriate for you to evaluate it with ICAS or IQAS. Yes, their own evaluation is totally different from that of WES. WES will evaluate your engineering degree, as 4 years, while they will evaluate it, equivalent to master's degree. And you can pick up the highest point, in demand pool for Saskatchewan, which is about 23 points thereabout. So let me read other questions available. Okay. Just a moment. Okay, thank you for your services, Nexi Limited. I have finally settled in UK now. I'm studying. It's going oh. Okay, thank you so much for the compliment. Really appreciate. Next is one of the best education. Okay, this is coming from Michael Gavin. Thank you, Michael Gavin. Really appreciate. Really appreciate you for joining. Thank you so much. Okay. So basically, I think those are the questions that are actually available on the chat. So if you want to ask, more questions, I can give you my WhatsApp number to reach me, and we can discuss more, like I said, on how you can maximize your work experience, how you can maximize your education, and how you can maximize the how you can calculate properly your language ability. That's your IELTS score, to give you a proper CLB score. So, and finally, how you can maximize the relationship. That's the family relationship. So if you send me a message on WhatsApp, I'm going to, assist you all through the process so that you can submit your expression of interest, and you will submit the right, indices. In case when you are submitting, or when you are getting an ITA, you would not have issues, basically, because that is very, very important. So thank you so much for joining. My WhatsApp number is 090. Let me just type it on this place. Calling it so that everybody can pick it. Okay. So I have it here, 08094402211. Thank you so much. Really appreciate your timing.